Aloha! Welcome to your online College of Natural Sciences orientation. This orientation was designed just for students who will be entering the College of Natural Sciences at the University of Hawaii at Manoa. In this video, I will show you how to effectively use the GPS registration tab in STAR to plan out all of your future coursework. Let's get started. First, we'll navigate to STAR by going to MyUH, logging in, and then clicking the STAR tile. Next, you'll log into STAR. Once you've logged in, if you aren't automatically directed to the GPS registration tab, then we'll need to click on it to get there. The tab is located right here. The GPS registration tab lays your courses out into semester blocks. Each semester has a set credit limit, shown here, which you can control by changing the value of this number.
I took a placement exam for Spanish and placed out of Spanish 202. After speaking with the department, I received a waiver for the second language requirement. For now, until that waiver processes, I can move my Hawaiian second language courses over to the sandbox as a temporary holding spot. For now, I can scroll through and look at the rest of my plan. Everything looks good for the most part.
But I don't want to hang out until spring 2021 just to take two more classes. I think that I can probably take those in the summer somewhere. So to help me move the credits from the bottom semester up to one of the top semesters, I'm just going to move them into the sandbox temporarily with the goal of moving them back out later. I'm going to scroll up and let's say I want to take one class in summer 2018 and another class in summer 2019. I can move this dynamic elective up to summer 2018, but there's no summer 2019 box, so I have to add it. And I do that just by clicking on the button that says Add Summer Semester. So I click there, and now I can move my other dynamic elective into the summer 2019 semester. Let's take a look at the classes that I'm thinking of taking next semester in fall 2018. I have a couple courses here for my major that I think I'll leave here for now, but I will meet with my major advisor just to double check and make sure that this is the correct semester for me to take those classes. I don't really know what I want to take for my 300 plus elective yet, so I think I'll actually switch that out with a different course. To switch it, I'll just click and drag it, move it around, and let's say next semester I'm thinking of taking a social science course instead. So I can do that, and every time I move a class, my initials appear next to it. Basically what that means is every time I refresh the page, those classes are locked in place and they cannot move around. Now I'm going to take a look at some of my options for these FG courses that I could take, or the Global and Multicultural Perspectives courses. So when I click here, it pulls up a list of all of the classes that I have the option of taking. And let's see, what is actually offered in fall? So when I click here on America and the World, American Studies 150, I can scroll down a little bit, I can see the course description, and I can also see the historical course stats. The last time this class was offered was in fall 2018. If I click over to spring, I can see that the enrollment data changes a little bit, but this does let me know that this class is also offered in the spring in case I decide to switch from taking it in the fall to taking it in the spring. If we continue to move down the list, you can see if there is anything that is not offered in the fall semester. So this class, for example, Survey of Global Art 2, Art 176. When we look at the fall enrollment data, there's nothing here. That means that this class probably is not offered in the fall, and sometimes you can also see in the course description it will say this class is spring only. That's good to know, so if I really wanted to take this class in fall 2018, then I'm not going to plan on taking Art 176. You can favorite up to a couple courses. I don't actually think that there is much of a limit here, but in my opinion, it's best to pick your top two or three for this list. So I'm thinking I want to take either American Studies, or Hawaiian 100, or Language Endangerment. That one sounds really interesting. Those are the three that I'm thinking of taking, and I can just click anywhere outside of this box to get back to the main GPS registration page. Now I can see those courses that I had starred plugged in here on the plan, and when I hover over it, it gives me the full list of the classes that I was thinking of taking. As for my social science courses, I don't know which one to take, and when I click on the list, the list is so long, it takes a really long time to load. This is so much to look through. So I'm actually not going to pick anything for my DS from this main menu, and we'll talk about selecting courses through the GPS registration interface in a future module. Throughout my plan, I have these elective 300 plus credits sitting around. I have 1, 2, 3, and I was actually thinking about maybe getting a certificate in Spanish language. Since I've already placed out of my second language, I'm thinking about continuing it because I really enjoyed that class. So if I click on elective 300 plus, I think after I spoke with my Spanish advisor, they were recommending that I take Spanish 301. So I can type that in, the class will come up. I can click on it and take a look and see some information about it. It looks like it probably be offered in the spring because there is some spring enrollment data. So I can leave that class there in the spring and consider taking Spanish 301 in spring 2019. My certificate, though, I do know is going to require at least 15 credits of upper division courses, and I only have 300 plus elective slots, which is about 9 credits. So that means I'm missing 2 course slots for my certificate. I could just use these elective classes here, but for the sake of showing you this really cool feature of STAR, I'm actually going to do something a little different. I'm going to click on this plus button, and you'll see that that opens up the add requirement menu. The add requirement menu will allow you to add additional course slots with these various labels. It's completely up to you which label you decide to pick. In my case, I'm pursuing a certificate. I think that's pretty close to a minor, so I can pick minor if I want to. And I can scroll down the list just to get a sense of what classes I might be able to take from my certificate. If I wanted to plug something in, then I could, but of course, I would definitely want to get it double-checked with my certificate advisor. Okay, I have one course plugged in there. Let's add one more. And then I'm going to refresh the page and then scroll down. You'll notice that my dynamic electives that were there disappeared because I no longer need them, and they've been replaced by minor course slots. Something to be concerned about with the way that you can just easily click and drag courses around is you always have to be mindful of course sequencing, especially as a student in the College of Natural Sciences. For example, I definitely can't take Chemistry 162 in lab before I take Chemistry 161. But what's going to stop me from moving Chemistry 162 before Chemistry 161 in the plan? Let's find out. I'm going to click on the class and move it up to Fall 2019. And when I do that, a couple warnings pop up. I'm exceeding the recommended diversity, which basically means I'm taking a lot of science classes in that semester. I'm also exceeding the recommended number of credits. I set the recommended number to 16, and by moving that class there, it set me above 16 credits. Finally, it does state General Chemistry 1 is recommended to come before General Chemistry 2. So do I want to make this change anyway and proceed? I'm going to say no. So I'm going to click no, and that just kicks the course back to the original semester where it came from. One group of classes that you don't see on the GPS registration page are your focus requirements. We can see focus requirements from the Academic Essentials page in the sense that I can take a look at which ones I have remaining. In this case, I have all of them remaining. And it can be a little annoying to have to flip back and forth from the Academic Essentials to GPS registration, so on and so forth. Luckily, I can actually access that same table right here from the GPS registration tab. On the right-hand side, underneath where it says Credits in Plan, there are a couple links that I can access right from here, and they include the focus requirements and also test scores so I can see when my test scores are available on my student record. This is especially useful because your chemistry and math placement exam results will show here. Knowing that I still have to take quite a few classes to fulfill my focus requirements, I might want to start planning out exactly where those go. So I'm thinking my Arts, Humanities, Literature requirement, I might want to try to double dip that with a writing intensive class. So I can make a note here, DA, DH, DL, writing intensive. Then when I hit enter, this note will then become a permanent part of this semester. At least until I decide to delete it by clicking on this red X. Another place where I can make such notes, rather than in the academic events section, is right here on this post-it icon. When I click there, it opens the semester notes block, and I can then write the same thing. Once I do that, I can click outside of that box, and you'll see that the note then becomes colored. That just means that there's writing in there, so when I click on it again, there are my notes. I can even expand my notes if I want to. And I can just continue on until I've made sure that I've met all of my focus requirements. The very last step to editing your graduation pathway is actually something that you can't just do on your own. That step is to meet with your academic advisor. So I've alluded to this a couple times throughout this video. I'm planning on meeting with my major advisor just to make sure that these are the right ICS courses that I should be taking in the fall. I'm going to meet with my certificate advisor for Spanish to make sure that I'm taking the right classes for that. I'd probably also want to meet with my college advisor just to make sure that I'm not missing anything in terms of my general education requirements and that I'll still be able to graduate on time. Once I've met with all of my advisors and made sure that my plan looks good, then I can proceed to register once my registration time ticket opens. That's it for the GPS registration tab. Are you ready for the mini quiz? Leave the GPS registration tab open so that you can refer back to this page to help you answer those questions.